My name is Alex Drilling, and the trait that I am doing is loving. Right before the summer, going into 8th grade, my house burned down. It started in my room, which I shared with my brother Colin, who was a year younger than me. The room was consumed in minutes. There was total destruction, and our house had to be all but knocked down in order to be repaired. It was traumatic, to say the least. However, I would like to focus on the good from this experience. No one in my family was hurt. We were displaced, and it caused stress and left scars in our minds, but we were all together. Over the next year of hardship and rebuilding, when we all crammed into a small house with my grandma, I learned a lot. I had to learn what it was like to own a few pairs of clothes, what it was like to have all of the physical representations of my childhood memories ripped away, and what it was like to live with 7 people in a 3-bedroom house. But I also learned how much my family meant to me, and how important they are to me. It was my family who was there when I woke up in the middle of the night with nightmares. They were there to help me through every step of the way. We each picked each other up when we were down, and together, we got through it. Wish we could turn back time to the good old days when the mama sang us to sleep, but now we're stressed out. Wish we could turn back time to the good old days. The next challenge my family faced was my parents' divorce. A little bit over a year since the fire, my parents told us that they wanted a divorce. The stress had been too much for them. From the fire, to my dad's business, to my parents' relationship, it had just been too much. This threw me into emotional disarray as I started my freshman year. I forced myself into my classes and football, just so I could distract myself from the turmoil that was my household. Months of fighting went on and on, and my dad moved out for a bit. I had to grow up, take care of my siblings, stand strong in front of them, and support them. It was around Christmas time, things got the worst. But then, they started to get better. My parents saw how broken we were, and the pain in our eyes. We sat there and opened our presents. And while we were grateful, my favorite time of the year turned into a quiet, sad few hours. Then, after a few months of being away, my dad decided that leaving our family was the worst thing he had ever done. It wasn't easy, but we worked long and hard for it, and now my family is one unit again. We went to counseling for months and spent many a night crying and arguing and hugging. We had been through too much as a family to lose each other. Through this experience, my family has grown stronger than it has ever been before, and now I trust my family with a trust that cannot be explained. Casting shadows, the sun was pushing through. Spoke a lot of words, I don't know if I spoke the truth. Got so much to lose. Got so much to prove. The latest issue that my family has faced started many years ago. It wasn't until recently, however, that our financial situation was devastated. My father's bank account manager at M&T had been stealing from us and M&T since 2004. He stole over $100 million. This ruined my dad's business, and he has been working day and night to salvage it for a while though. When we first found out about it,
I didn't know if I could finish my years at Canisius, which had become a safe haven for me for when it had been stressful at home. It's been difficult making decisions because of this financial situation, and having to worry about college costs, paying for lunch, and having only a few pairs of pants and shirts. But the worst part was the strain on my parents. They don't sleep. My dad works 14-hour days and then comes home and works more on the case. It has caused so much stress and anger in my house that some days there's a tension in the air that could be cut by a knife. But we worked through it. We've been challenged before, and even though it is difficult, we work together and can stay strong. It's been difficult to stay positive through all these major events in my life. I have struggled with the questions of, why is this happening to me? What did I do to deserve this? Why would a loving God put my family through all of this? I have had times when I didn't want to be part of this family. Nights when I couldn't sleep because of the pain I felt. Days when I couldn't speak. There have been times when I have fought with a sibling or argued with my parents and I thought I would never be able to fix it. But I love my family, and they love me. Love is powerful, and has kept my family together through all of these problems. These problems taught me how to love, and what love truly means. My family has gone through a fire, a divorce, and losing our income. But we are all still here, together, and no one can take us apart. My family means the world to me, and no matter what happens, I will have them there to help me get through it. This love and trust that I have learned has taught me to become a more caring and open person.
Is it raining where you are? The only thing I could think to ask.
One particular family vacation with my friend Brendan holds a special place in my memories. Brendan's mom had a near-fatal stroke in second grade, and then he found his dad dead on the couch from a heart attack in third grade. Because of this, he didn't get to go out much or go on vacations. So for a couple of years, my family took him with us on our family vacations. My freshman year spring break, we went to Florida, and it was the first time we did something as a family since the divorce, which had happened the last summer. Brendan didn't know much about the divorce, and in order to make the trip go smoothly and stay strong for Brendan, my family was forced to be happy for the trip. However, because we thought we had to function as an actual family, we ended up doing so naturally. And it turned out to be one of the best trips my family has ever had. We had a great time relaxing on the beach and forgetting about our problems for a while. Brendan was there for me during that time, and he made that vacation go smoothly. He was always there for me when I needed it, and I was always there for him. He was even sleeping over the day of the fire. He's been as much a part of my family growing up is one of my actual brothers, and I'm so grateful that I can call him my friend. Speaking of friends, I have a small group of friends that I've spent most of the last 2 years with. Tori, Sean, Maddie, and Sophia are all wonderful people, and they have changed me immensely. They are so different from everyone else I know, and they have helped me to learn a lot about empathy. Some of my friends do not hold the same political views, sexual preferences, and opinions as myself, and it has been a learning experience to talk with them. I have had to educate myself on many perspectives so that I don't offend anyone. I remember most well a family trip during Memorial Day weekend down to Tennessee. It was for a family friend's graduation party, Katie. She is our age, but skipped a grade. And during the year before, my friends had become really good friends with her. And so, they were also invited. But only Tori and Sean ended up coming with me. This trip was a fantastic few days. But my favorite was the hike we took to the Smoky Mountains. We spent the day walking and taking pictures. Looking out across the mountains made me feel small, but it also filled me with a sense of hope. I was with the people I cherished most, and being with them comforted me. It felt to me as if the mountains pushed us all together. We had no cell service and a long day together. There wasn't much to do besides enjoy the beauty of the mountains and talk with each other. Much like a retreat, we forgot about time and the problems we have to go back to, and we just enjoyed being in each other's company. We didn't do much, but it was some of the most quality time I've ever spent with my family and friends. That weekend taught me a lot about inviting people into my life, and I began to understand what a true friend means. Through this trip and the rest of my summer, my friends grew into people who I now consider family. I don't really consider myself a happy person, but I try my hardest. This school has taught me so much about what it means to be a man and how to have a relationship. It has helped me cope with the pain in more ways than anyone can imagine. I learned to put myself in others' shoes and see life from their perspective, and to give my time to others in need. And since then, I have been able to reason that I still have my family and my friends, and while some things go wrong, I will always have them here for me to help me along. While my life has had its ups and downs, the downs are easier to deal with when you work to be a man for and with others. You no longer think about what is wrong with yourself, but you start to think, what can I do to make others better? This has caused me to develop deeper and more meaningful relationships and has allowed me to open up more to new people. And through this mentality, I have learned how to be a more happy person.